12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And first up this week, we'll have a little chat about what we've been up to. You've had a haircut, I'm about to have a haircut.
I've also had McDonald's still.
Yeah, you've
bigger,
had McDonald's.
Bigger again from 2 weeks ago.
We had a fried breakfast out today.
I know, a fried breakfast out, and I went to a restaurant yesterday for lunch and dinner. And
Oh my goodness.
I've been to pubs, and I'm riddled now. I'm riddled with it.
I've done a few online shows since for regular clients of mine. Not something that I've advertised, but again, I know we mentioned this before, Virtual Triumph was one of the highlights of the show.
It's brilliant.
For my client when they spread the cards. And so look back on the previous Wizard Product Review for the review of Adrian Lacar's Virtual Triumph, because again, having used that was brilliant. I will stand by that 100% review. Absolutely fantastic. I'm planning an online lecture for about a month's time. I am doing one lecture for the Italian Magic Conference, but I'm doing them in the future for magic clubs. We can get that together. You've been doing online lectures,
And they've been going brilliantly.
I know.
I mean, I've modified it. So if you've had my lecture before at your clubs, it's a completely different lecture. There's three interactive Zoom tricks on there, which have been going down really well. The one that's been getting the most attention off people is the Cards Across routine, where you actually make a card as the magician disappear for a pack of cards in your hands, wherever your house is, travel through the ether and appear into a spectator's pocket who's watching on Zoom somewhere.
So the spectator is convinced their pocket's empty during the process of the trick.
They put a number of cards in their pocket.
So they're taking other cards.
They've counted out five cards and put them in their pocket. You make a card disappear from your hands and then reappear in their pocket. So they've counted five cards in and six cards come out. And it fries them. It's really good.
That sounds great. I want to learn that.
Yeah.
When's your next lecture?
Well, taking bookings now. And I'll send you a video of that.
All right. Okay. We'll put some clips on the screen. That sounds great, actually. So how do people get in touch with you?
Find me on Facebook at Card Trick King. I'll go to my website, seanheydon.co.uk.
Worldwide. Mind getting up at 2 in the morning.
I'll do a lecture at 2 o'clock. I get up for a wee every night at 2 o'clock in the morning. So I might as well have some money whilst I'm doing it.
First review this week, that's it. Oh, we do want to mention as well, if you're watching this show on Facebook, if you're on your desktop now on Facebook, hopefully you see that on the World Magic Shop Facebook page, we do not spam you with loads of videos. In fact, since the Wizard Product Review last time, I shared one video of this amazing act, the card magician with the blank cards from America's Got Talent. I shared one video and the Wizard Product Review, and it's always like that. Unless we have a brand new product at World Magic Shop, and just at World Magic Shop, you'll only get the Wizard Product Review. So it's worth you going on, where it says follow at the top on Facebook, hit follow of course, but then tick favourites. That way you're going to see us first.
And if you're watching us on YouTube, even though you might be subscribed to the channel, it might not mean that you get notifications of every time the Wizard Product Review is loaded. So if you'd go onto the Wizard of the World Magic Shop page, turn notifications on, and then every time the review show is uploaded, you will get a notification.
It's the only videos we put on the YouTube channel. So if you don't want to miss the Wizard Product Review, that's how you won't miss it on Facebook and on YouTube. The first review this week is a trick called Untruth by Rich Lee, who heralds from New York. It's a typical sort of Sans Mines productions. You get your very flashy trailer, looks incredible, moment of magic, where the four kings turn into four eights at your fingertips and then very cleanly and very convincingly are turned over and turned back into the four kings at the end. Now, I've got to confess, not that I bought it as a review copy, but I think you might have a bit of buyer's remorse when you first open it up and you see the gimmick. Because when you first look at it, you kind of go, is that it?
Well,
but actually,
it's good.
It's good.
And I think there's generational things going on here. So I think a young boy magician under the age of 30,
or girl.
25 or girl magician, but a young magician might not have that buyer's remorse that you've got.
Right.
And I'll tell you why.
Why is that?
I'll tell you, because I remember both
me and you. Don't they get disappointed when they get a couple of cards
me
stuck
and you
together
were going,
with stuff?
We were going through a bit in our lives, and we'd go, no, social media magic, Instagram magic, but we had to be taught that was okay. I think I'm going to do this. In fact, I've already done it. I really like it. Right. However, I don't think it's something that I would do at a live gig. It's something that would be a great clip for Instagram.
You've already filmed it.
And I've already filmed it and I've already done it. I really like it. Can't do a live gig. But so I think if you're of that generation of magician that are coming up and most of their performances are maybe to get followers on Instagram or something, you'll see massive potential in this. But whereas somebody that was thrown into the trenches like me and you and we review stuff by going, can I do that at TGI Fridays? No, you can't because they're still closed.
Yeah.
But if they were open, the answer's still no, you maybe wouldn't be so confident doing it at a live gig.
So what do you get with it? You get a gimmick which is made up. You get a 30-minute tutorial as such, which about 20 minutes of the whole tutorial, as well as a studio performance, which looked a lot outside, just showing the move. It's the same clip from the trailer, basically, is the studio performance. So there's no patter or anything like that. Rich just demonstrates the move. The next 20 minutes is how to make the gimmick. So showing you how to construct it from scratch. And then the last sort of 5 minutes or so is showing you how to handle it.
Yeah.
You were up and running with it in less than 5 minutes.
Yeah, I ran through the moves like 5 or 6 times. Then we filmed the video. It works. You could, you know, if you want to practice it, it'll be great. It's a great clip for your Instagram.
Yeah, you've got the whole clip. Well, the clip's like 26 seconds, isn't it? So it's a perfect length of clip for Instagram. If you like doing that sort of thing, it's not really any sort of thing that people would visit me for, is to see some flashy card move. So I wouldn't upload a clip like that. You can't really use it in the real world anyway, I don't think.
That is the real world now.
No, it's not.
That is the world. Okay, when was the last time that you did magic at a gig?
A virtual show.
No, exactly. An actual ad gig.
My electrician saw a trick the other day. There we go. That's it. Look, I can't give this anymore. I'm impressed. When Rich did it, I was like, wow, that looks great. It looks good on video, but it's no use to me. I'm not going to use it. It doesn't fit my brand. It's not what I'm doing. It's not my character. For that reason, I'm giving it 65%, but it works. Not for me.
I am going to do it. In fact, I've already filmed it for a social media clip, and therefore I have to give this 90%.
Exactly 90%. All your gimmicks are in there, everything you need, as well as a DVD.
A what?
A DVD.
You can get cream for that, can't you?
I know. We've got a competition prize this week, and it's a DVD from Big Blind Media. We reviewed this previously, got a great review. Digits of Deception by Alan Rorison. So you could win this just by simply commenting below on the Wizard product review, and we need to do something. So, Alan Rorison, where does he reside? I know where he lives, so where does he reside? Where is he? Which country is he from? Not his exact address, which country is he from?
In fact, there's another magician from that country that everybody's looking for too. I think his name's David Forrest, I've got no idea why. So if you could tell us where David Forrest
is. No, we don't need to know, but yeah, it is true. There are people looking for him. I think they're late with their shipments or something. But Alan Rorison, just comment and we'll pick somebody for next time to receive Digits of Deception for free. We'll get that sent over to you. Comment below. We are going to start this video now. That's just so I can sync it up later.
Sync clap. We are going to do a trick called Fortuity by Alakazam and David Jonathan.
So are you showing that camera? Yeah. I'm here.
David Jonathan. Yeah, it's like a proper show of his name though, isn't it? David Jonathan. And in this trick, you are going to get a little envelope, and the envelope is a prediction. I guess with the routine, it's up to you whether you introduce a prediction now or later. I'm going to introduce it now.
It's an open prediction.
The prediction really is here. And you also have a pack of cards and some dice. We'll go on to the dice in a minute. But Dave, could you just have to take out a couple of cards for me?
Okay.
And just have a look at them. Do you notice anything different about them?
Ah, they've got different, they're trick cards. They've got different colour backs.
Different on the front and different on the back. Not just on the front, I'll show you every single card in here really, really is different. You really can show them very fairly to everybody. They're very, very well done. And we have these dice. Dave, will you give the dice a roll to make sure that they land on different numbers each side? So you've got a 2 and a 2. Very good. Two little ducks there. A 5 and 1, which is 6. Now we're going to do it for real now. Now you're going to roll the dice. the dices. We have a six, and we're going to count down. Do you want to go from the top or the bottom? You choose.
The top.
The top. We're going to count down to the six card. That's one, two, three, four, five, and six.
Yeah.
And we've got this card here, and you could have picked any of them. So okay. That's quite questionable. And now we're going to do from the bottom as well. In fact, if you went for the six card from the bottom, one, two, three, four, five, six, you have a card that looks like this on the back.
Yeah.
Okay. But just roll the dice again for me. Roll the dice again.
Right. Okay.
So that is an 11, a 6 and a 5, 11.
11.
We're going to go to the 11th card. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. The King of Diamonds here. And you could have picked any one of these cards.
Yeah.
All right. Now, in here, I had a little prediction. It's been in this envelope the whole time. And in here, I've actually predicted that you would stop there on the King of Diamonds. You can check the envelope as well, make sure there's nothing in it.
Nothing else.
And not only that, the chances of me getting that are crazy.
Crazy.
Well, it would be even crazier if I could predict the back, and not only was predicted the front, was predicted the back. And that is Fortuity by David Jonathan.
Dun, dun, dun. A double finish there. So what do you get with it? First of all, you get Dave loosely on a download link, talking for about 40 minutes about the effect. And what you get with it, you get a specially produced deck of cards, and I'm not going to show anything about it, but it really is a very nice sort of rainbow style deck of cards there. Every single card is different. And the clever thing about this deck, the clever thing about it, is it's set up in a certain way that you can actually hand cards to people at the start, and people can check those cards, make sure that they're kosher, they are just normal cards with different colour backs, and they check that during the process, don't they?
Yeah, and also there's a few things to say about this, and the Ghana DVD is doing lots of shuffly bits with it, yeah. Things like that. I'd maybe argue too many, but the point is that the trick in itself is, well, I've run through it once, I've watched the instructions, and we've just done it then. We've just done it out of the box. It works. The cards are made. It might be using a principle that you may or may not be familiar with, but even if you are, it's done in a way that it's actually quite a clever way, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's very well made.
It's like Joe Riding's sort of split decision, in a way, isn't it? It's a very sort of similar effect where the two cards match and then the back design matches as well.
Yeah, I always struggle with, so if there is a problem with it, without it being too hard, with predictions like this, I always struggle because there's a card at the end that you never see the face of. So I'm always like, I want a third thing to happen.
Yeah.
I want that card to turn over, then maybe you have another prediction in your pocket. That's how it'd finish off to be a brilliant, 90-95% routine.
Yeah.
But it doesn't do that, but it's still very baffling. Your spectators won't know how to do it, and it will work. It's easy to do.
Do you know
as well.
What I just thought of? That'd be a bit of a crazy thing. Like, the envelope's in view, right? You could almost have a red envelope, and the red envelope, it looked like an envelope, there's nothing inside, but at the end you pop the envelope open and the envelope's actually a huge prediction.
Yeah, of that one.
Yeah, no, of a red envelope becomes the red back with the king inside or something like that. So it's actually, it's in view. In fact, you didn't even realise it's been here the entire time. Look.
It's like a Darren Brown special.
And then, you know, the band comes on and sings the prediction song.
Well, they can't do that in a minute. No singing. You can't sing at the minute.
Sorry, you can't have that. It's a good job. The dice, they are sort of black and red, sort of mixed together, plastic.
They look classy. They're classy dice.
They're classy looking dice. There's nothing funny about the dice, so you could change them if you wanted to. If you wanted it a bigger routine, a stage routine, you could change the dice if you wanted to.
Yeah, but you're buying it. A very well-made, special pack of cards.
It just works. It's a pipe and slippers moment. It just works. I'm going to give this 85%.
Yeah, I'm not going to go quite that high. Like I said, I'd like something extra to happen at the end. It does work. It works very well. I'm going to give it 81%.
Yeah, I think you could think about that kicker, though, at the end, and probably add something. Third review on the... it's a card magic special this month, isn't it? It's SPINLAB presents Colours.
Colours, that's it. I forgot. I lost a little bit and I forgot.
Well, let's talk about that for for a moment. It's hardly any great packaging. It's not going to be on the shelf at a magic shop and you think, I've got to have that. It's not like...
It reminded me of my washing up days when I was 40 years old. That's something I used to get my wages in, and they'd write my name there, the amount of money I got there. And how much trouble I was in there for
washing, the hanging up, washing up for money. Are they hiring?
Yeah, they are. Yeah, they're hiring.
Right, let's get in there.
So it's like a multi-stage packet trick. I'll address the cards first. They're better than some packet trick cards in the quality of the cards. I wouldn't say they were up there.
Plasticky, aren't they?
Yeah, they weren't. They're not up there with the USPCC bicycle playing cards.
Like the 52-1.
Like the 52-1 deck. But they're well made. They're good. They are durable, and they will last for a while, I'd imagine.
So let's talk about the routine. First of all, you start off, you've got four blank cards. You show those blank cards, and one by one, every single one of the backs prints by magic. Each one individually prints. And then one of the backs unprints, which I kind of find a little bit disjointed in the routine. Makes no sense. But then you show all the faces are the four aces. And then you place the four cards together, all together, and very cleanly on the video. It looks absolutely incredible. Those four cards become one, and all the aces are merged onto one card. So you get like an interesting finale card. The moves are within the
this intermediate magic.
Yeah.
The only thing that
Elmsies, Hammonds, Frustrations, Asiano.
There's a couple of nice visual bits in it, which I'm sure will have been on the screen already, but I'm going to say about them, where there's some really nice visual colour changes that happen in your hands that, again, aren't beyond the realms of an intermediate card magician. The only bit there is seems a little bit fluffy at the end, which if you are an intermediate magician, you will be able to figure out a way around this, is the vanish of, the merging of the four cards into just one card for the big finale. I don't believe the way that it's taught is something that you maybe want to be doing in every single situation.
You can't do it. I'll go on record and say you can't do it. As a gigging magician, you're not going to be able to do this in a gig situation.
But there is
you're going to need to be sat down for a start.
I do, at the end of one of my routines, in fact, it's one of my finales for Darwin Ortiz's live poker routine, I make the whole deck vanish at the end. Using a much easier deck vanish, but the same type of deck vanish that's taught on here, that is a bulletproof way of doing it. So if you are an intermediate card magician, you'll be able to fix that problem at the end.
Can I just say, I would imagine somebody, a good friend of ours, Matt McGurk, who does the magic on the ships on the live camera, and every now and then he does a bit with coins or cards, and it's almost like meditation. And he's doing like incredible card sleight of hand. Yeah. And I can imagine somebody like Matt using something like that, solving the problems
in
with
like
it.
A sting song then. He deals the cards.
Well, that's
a meditation. I mean, so I don't know anybody that might have done card magic to that sort of music.
No.
But you're not implying that Matt McGurk does, are you?
No.
Because that controversy, we don't want to be picking that up.
He definitely doesn't. No, you've not got the rights to do that. The thing is, I can imagine somebody on the screen putting a nice bit of music on and doing this effect, and an appreciative of audience that were there to watch magic enjoying it. It's not for me. I wouldn't use it. I'm not going to use it on a screen. Not going to use it on an Instagram clip. Not going to use it live because I don't think you can. But it's produced nicely, and if you're into that sort of magic, you might like it. I'm not. I'm giving it 40% because it's really, really not for me at all.
See, I think it's better than that.
No.
I'm never going to do it. I'm not going to do it. If I was 16 years old again, I'd be buying that because it's got all the moves I was learning.
So you're going to give it good marks if you were 16 years old?
I'm saying anybody that's getting into magic, anybody that's trying to practice them moves, it's a good training ground. This, it's got a lot of things in it.
When you were 16, you used to do squared circle in your number one set.
No, I didn't. I did. Imagine this now. I did, however, used to go to tables at restaurants on 16 and pull mouth coils out of my mouth and all that. Imagine
spit all over their food.
Spit all over their food. Yeah. Imagine doing that. Anyway, I'm going to give this not super high, but if you're learning card magic, I think you should get it. I'm going to give this 69%.
All right. Available from Card Shark, we've got Warped in Space by Quentin Reynolds. Open a portal to the other side. And we mentioned this on the last Wizard product review when we reviewed Machinations by Ben Harris. And Quentin was kind enough to actually send us a review copy.
Yeah. And as part of Dave's tour, Dave's obviously is on tour at the minute.
Bathroom.
Yeah. He was in the kitchen last week.
Yeah.
And his electrician was there.
Yeah, because we mentioned on the last week's show that we showed a trick to the builder, which we did, which was the credit card thing, which went down really well. And we heard him arguing with the electrician, Mike, upstairs. And then a couple of days later, when Quentin had sent this, Mike came down.
And bought a ticket to David's kitchen show.
The real in-person show. And we actually performed this, so we'll show you some clips on the screen. So what is Warped Space and Time? First of all, we should say that Quentin does this as a follow-up to Card Warp. So I think this is probably the reason this has gone under a lot of people's radar, because the trailer is not so good for, like, you know, Christian is a friend. You know, I've been out to dinner with him at Blackpool and that. But I'll go on record and I'll say, I don't think the trailer's as good as it should be, pointing out what is unique about this product.
No, that's it.
Because when the trailer starts, for the first 3 or 4 minutes, most people are just watching Quentin doing Card Warp.
Yeah.
And you've got to admit to yourself as a magician, you're looking at it, you're going, I don't understand what this is. It's Card Warp. And you have to get a long way into the trailer until you realise what is unique about it. But the thing that's unique is the fact that they end up with a very amazing souvenir, which freezes the moment of magic perfectly, which is actually kind of like a follow-up to that trapdoor principle that was explored in the Machinations book. The reason I don't like Quentin's presentation is because he uses all the Card Warp before and he takes so long getting to the gold. The gold is just the bit with the trapdoor, as far as I'm
you
concerned.
You have just...
I know, I've disrespected his memory.
There's a portal there, right, and you've just ripped open another time-space portal. There is a lot of people out there that are massive fans of Card Warp.
I know.
A good friend of mine, David Deeney, that I know, I don't know if he does now, I think he lives in a similar area as Quentin, that does Card Warp, or did Card Warp.
I know, it's controversial.
And he also used to do Hypercard, which Roy Walton also came up with, which created an impossible souvenir as well. But it was, but why this is better than that is this is an impossible souvenir that can't be broken apart or twisted or torn, which lasts forever.
Yeah,
it's brilliant.
It carries on from... So, this is the way I presented it for the electrician. I know you've seen clips on the screen. I said a lot of people wonder how stage illusions are done. It's normally one of two ways. There's either a mirror or there's a trapdoor you're not familiar with. I tore the trapdoor in the card and then got him to hold on to it. And he signed it, and he passed through the trapdoor. And there's a point when you're signing it, it is actually incredible because you convince them that the card is in exactly the same position. Mm. And when the card's ready to do the magic, you've done your mischief bit, the card looks exactly the same as it did before when he first saw it, and you can have a gag with it. I'm going to push you through this trapdoor, and you just put your finger through the hole or push your head through the trapdoor.
Yeah.
You go through, you're pushing it like this, and then, joking aside, after your moment of relaxation, you sign the card, David, Penn, you open it, they sign it, and then you can show this card, which looks great, on both sides. You show it on both sides, signed, they hold on to it, and you've got this great moment at the end where it's reversed, it ends up completely reversed. They were looking at the back, now all they can see is the face. And you can say to them, do you believe that you actually passed through the trapdoor? And they're going to say no. And then you say, close the trapdoor. And only when they close the trapdoor, they realise at that moment in the time, they've got their impossible souvenir. And I think this bit that engages the spectator so much is actually better than just Card Warp leading into it.
Yeah,
I think it's better just to take a card out of your wallet, an ace of clubs, fold it up, show the trapdoor, do this trick. You also get with it these kind of clear envelopes, and the clear envelopes, you can put your business card inside there and the souvenir card, and they can keep that souvenir and take it home with them. You get enough of the clear envelopes, you get enough of the cards for 26 performances.
Which is good. So that's 26 chances to get yourself another gig.
Yeah.
So this is an investment.
Yeah, and what was funny, wasn't it? We caught the builder. Sorry, the electrician.
We caught him. I think he was walking past Dave. We thought he was leaving. We actually go get here now. You've got a show. The show's not. I know you might have come to buy the new TV, but the show's not over yet.
He's not seen the show. He's coming back to do the doorbell. We're going to find some other tricks.
That reminds me of when I was a kid. I'm like, Mom, I'm going to show you a trick. Have you cooked your dinner? No, now, come on. You've got to do it now. Set it up.
Going to come back in and watch this. Yeah. But we caught him actually later, didn't we? We took a sneaky photo.
Yeah, because he said he was too busy to start with, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he did, yeah. But then he sat there while he was having his tea.
Oh, come on then, show me it now.
We took a picture of him, like struggling, going, how the hell did that work? We actually caught. And he was thinking about it for ages and ages afterwards, and he did take it home. It's totally impossible souvenir. I really like this. I'm going to give this one 90%. I think it's my highest review of the week. I'm giving it exactly 90%.
Absolutely the same. I love it. I think it's brilliant. It's an impossible souvenir that they really can take away. I am going to give this 92%.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Don't forget, on your Facebook page or on your YouTube, make sure you've got notifications and favourites selected, see us first, that kind of thing. Select all those things so you don't miss an episode of the Wizard Product Review. Until then, we'll see you next time in about 2 weeks' time. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review. Good. Yeah.